Hey everybody, Roby here with the Divi Engine team, coming at you with yet another Divi Engine quick tip. And today we're going to be working with Divi Machine. One of the cool things you can do with Divi Machine is maybe you're on a archive page like this one. We've got a cool map there and stuff, but you want an additional button here that when you click on it, that it doesn't just take you to the single post page like this one. As you can see, I've got a download here. That could be a floor plan, it could be a spec sheet, it could be anything you want it to be. That's not the important part, but maybe you want a button on that loop that brings you right to this part of the post. So that's what we'll be doing today. Now, if you don't have Divi Machine, what are you waiting for? There's a discount link in the description of this video for you to go score some savings on Divi Machine. And for those of you that do have Divi Machine, well, you're very smart. Glad to have you. Now, definitely like and subscribe this channel, these videos, and make sure that you squeeze every bit of your investment out of your Divi Engine plugins. So that's enough from me. Why don't we get right into it? Okay, guys. So for this to work, you are going to need a part on the single post page that you want to be able to scroll to when you click that button on the front end. Now that's one part of the equation. The other part is that you need to add another button to your loop layout, and that's what we'll do first here. All right, so here I am on the back end of my Divi site. I have Divi Machine installed and I have my loop layout here in front of me. Here we can see I've got my view post button, and that is just the normal one. So let's add another one. Now I am just going to go type in view, and of course that'll bring up the view post button. And right here you can give the button the custom name, and I am just going to put in download. And you can, of course, put whatever you want. Maybe it's buy now. Maybe you want to take them to the actual buy now part of that page. Whatever you want. This is just to get the juices flowing. But the part we're focused on here is the custom URL end. Now, this is where we can go ahead and insert an anchor link. So what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to put hash download as my anchor. I'm going to go ahead and save this. I'm going to go ahead and update. Okay, now that should be pretty good. We have to do one more thing. Now, let's just go to the layout for our classifieds post type. That's the one that I'm using here. And we're going to go scroll down to that download section that we can see right down here. Okay, so all we need to do is go to that section, or maybe you want to go to this header or whatever you want. You just go click on the settings, you go to advanced, and then right over here in the CSS ID, guess what you're going to do? You're just going to go ahead and type in download, this time without the hash, because this already knows it's a CSS ID. Divi is smart enough to add that hash in there for you. So just go ahead and save that. Save the page or the layout. And then we'll pop in on the front end. We'll go to all classifieds here. And now when I scroll down here, I know that my living room has a download. So when I click on that button, bam, we're right here on the download section. And just to make sure that I am not doing any type of trickery here with you, let's just go back and scroll down to that post yet again and hit that view post button. And there it is right at the top for the same post. Now, guys, for those of you more experienced with Divi Machine, you know that there's some ways you can hide certain things based on whether there is a download file or not. You can hide the button on the actual loop layout. Lots of stuff. I'll put that in another Divi Engine quick tip for you here in the future. So with that, guys, we did some cool stuff today. You learned a new thing. Again, please like and subscribe. Comment on these videos. It really helps us know what you guys are looking for, what we can help you learn more in the Divi Engine suite of plugins. So guys, with that, I appreciate you for being here. It's been me. It's been real. And I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.